Hello everyone, welcome back to the Synthax UK YouTube channel. My name is Matt and today I'm going to be taking you through the easiest way of connecting your RME ADI-2 DAC FS or your RME ADI-2 Pro FSR to an audio interface like the RME Babyface Pro FS. This is a question that we've been asked quite a few times recently. So if you're looking to combine the reference class sound quality of the DAC or Pro FSR with the recording and routing flexibility of RME's interfaces and sound cards, then this is the video for you. Both the DAC and the Pro can also be used as USB class compliant interfaces. And I'll be showing you how to do that a little bit later on in this video. But for now, I'm just going to dive in. And it's worth noting that I'll be using a Mac for this tutorial, but these steps are exactly the same on PC as well. I've got my RME Babyface Pro connected to my computer over here. And I've got my ADI-2 DAC FS turned on over here. Now to connect these two, we need Toslink cables. Now if you don't have Toslink cables, they are relatively inexpensive and really easy to get hold of. So for this connection, we just need one of these. It's worth noting that the DAC understands both ADAT and SPDIF formats as well as AES3. So it would work with any of those three connections as long as you have all the right cabling to go along with it. So to connect the two devices, I'm simply going to take the optical Toslink cable and I'm going to take it from the ADA output of my Babyface Pro and connect this to the optical input of the ADI-2 DAC. So just to clarify, the audio is being passed digitally from my computer to my interface via USB. This is then going from ADAT into the DAC. The DAC is then converting this digital signal into an analog signal, which is then being passed into my speakers or headphones for monitoring. As soon as I connect the optical cable, the DAC will automatically switch over to using the optical input. We can check this via the status screen on the front panel. Next up, I'm going to go over to my Mac and I'm going to open the RME settings dialog. If you can't immediately see it, check your applications folder on a Mac or on Windows, check the System32 folder. And the icon is the RME logo with a bit of fire above it. Here I can set the sample rate as well as the clock, which I'll set to internal. And we can check everything is connected correctly by looking at the front panel of the DAC, which will show both the sample rate and the sync, which confirms the connection. Now I just need to open RME's Total Mix Effects software controller and route some audio to the ADA output. Now on my Babyface Pro, this first channel is called AS1 and 2 because it represents the ADAT and SPDIF channels together. So in some interfaces, this may say AS1 and 2, in others it may say ADAT 1 and 2. Alternatively, if you're using a different interface with SPDIF or AES, you'll of course need to select the respective SPDIF or AES output channels instead. I'm also going to go down to the right hand corner and use the assign drop down to set AS1 and 2 as my main output, which will allow me to take advantage of some of Total Mix's control room functions such as mono and dim. Now that I've got the output highlighted, I'm going to route some audio to it from the software playback row, say my DAW or web browser, then turn up the fader. Audio is now being routed from the Babyface's optical output into the ADI-2 DAC, which I can confirm by turning up the volume on the DAC. And that's it, I'm now free to use the ADI-2 DAC's converters with my speakers and headphones for some incredibly detailed monitoring. For the ADI-2 Pro FSR, two optical Toslink cables are required, and that's because we have both a digital in and a digital out. So to start, I'm going to connect the inputs and outputs together. So I'm going to make sure that the ADAT out of the ADI-2 Pro FSR is connected to the ADAT in of the Babyface Pro and vice versa. Next, we'll look at the clocking between the two devices. To take advantage of RME SteadyClock FS, I'll be using the Pro as the device that our clock signal is taken from. If you're unfamiliar with SteadyClock FS and digital format conversion, our friends at RME Germany have got a video that explains just that. On the ADI-2 Pro, simply press the Setup button, then find the Options menu and scroll to the Clock section. From here, I'll change Clock Source to Internal, so that the Pro is clock master, and set the sample rate, which I'm going to leave at 48 kilohertz. Now I'm ready to make some adjustments in the Fireface USB settings program. If you can't find this, search the applications folder if you're on Mac and the system32 folder if you are on Windows. I need to make sure that the sample rate matches that chosen on the ADI-2, and in clock source I need to choose optical in rather than internal, so the interface now takes its clock signal from the ADI-2. Now I need to move over to Total Mix Effects to set up the main output. Let's start by going over to the control room section and choosing assign, and in the main out section choosing AS 1 and 2. That means anything associated with my main out submix will be sent to the ADI-2 for monitoring. And it also means I can make use of all the control room functionality in Total Mix. Now, on my Babyface Pro, this first channel is called AS1 and 2 because it represents the ADAT and SP diff channels together. So in some interfaces, this may say AS1 and 2, in others it may say ADAT 1 and 2. Alternatively, if you're using a different interface with SPDIF or AES, you'll of course need to select the respective SPDIF or AES output channels instead. So I have some audio coming out of software playback AM1 and 2, and by clicking my main out and turning this up, it's now sent to my monitors. Equally for the inputs, any analog connections I make to the ADI-2 Pro will show up in the AS1 and 2 input channels in the top row of Total Mix. As mentioned previously, both the ADI-2 DAC FS and ADI-2 Pro FSR can be used as USB class compliant audio devices. This means that they can both be plugged directly into a computer or even a phone or tablet and used as a playback device over USB and a two-channel recording device in the case of the ADI-2 Pro FSR. For this, you only require a USB-B type cable. Simply plug the ADI-2 unit directly into your computer and it will be recognized without the need for an interface. To make sure that the sound is being sent to the ADI-2 DAC or Pro FSR, go to your machine's sound settings and make sure that the unit is chosen as the output. The sample rate can usually be changed through the sound settings on your machine, as well as via the settings of whichever program you'll be using it with, whether that's a DAW or through a media player like Spotify or Tidal. And that's it, I've now connected up my audio interface with either the ADI-2 DAC or Pro FSR, and that means I now get reference class, crystal clear, transparent audio conversion for my monitoring or headphones. And I hope you found this video useful. If you have, please do make sure that you like the video and subscribe to our channel, and you get to see all of our future content first. Thanks very much, guys. I will see you again next time.